people to hold it for pictures, and then you can
sure
do whatever you want with them.
Taking a quick video, so.
Oh yeah. Okay. Well, that's, you know, okay. Well,
yeah, you're better.
Keeping the bike lanes on Jarvis.
Fabulous. Let's keep the lanes.
Keep the lanes.
Weddings will be, I think, Shinto, but like funerals will be Buddhist.
Really? Do you want to renew today and get it for $20?
$40?
Yeah. Take that.
Underway. First of all, I'd like to introduce a resident in the area. Her name's June McDonald. Give it up for June.
Yes, yes!
Good afternoon. Wow. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm here to represent. A long time resident of the area. For the past 25 years, and until the bike lanes went in last year, I wasn't able to use those bike lanes. And now I use them practically every day to go shopping, to go to appointments, whatever, whatever. It really, really makes a difference. I just want to say that around this area, about 75% of the people do not drive to work. And in my condo, half the cars are there all day long because people are using other ways of getting around. So there's a mythology that the gas tax pays for the road, but it comes out of our property and rental taxes. So we're all paying for the roads, and we all should be able to use it to get around in our community. This is really densely populated area. We need to get around. Thank you.
Thanks, June. Sorry, guys. Next up, I'd like to introduce Councillor Shelley Carroll, who's going to say a few words.
Thank you.
security issues. I just wanted to see if I could use that siren. Where's Councillor Fletcher? The Fletch is going to ride with you. Where'd she go? Wait, Fletch!
Next to the speaker.
Why am I here? I'm the councillor from north of the 401. Well, today is Toronto East Community Council. The councillors from the part of our cycle plan around here had community council today. They were doing that work. I saw them work together and more efficiently than ever because they knew there was a bike rally. Paul is here. Chris Wong-Tam is going to be waiting for you when you get to Nathan Phillips Square. I'm kind of glad that I got to come because I wanted to tell you that this is a fight. It's coming right up in Nathan Phillips Square. I want you to pedal all the way to NPS because Kristen's going to tell you exactly when the next step is. She's going to tell you exactly where we need your bodies to be to win this next month. But I wanted to also tell you to keep rallying all summer and to keep going out there and looking for your natural partners in this community. We got a problem with one of the trailways in this plan out in the suburbs near where I live. I went out to meet with the people saying no cycling infrastructure here. And when I got to the site, what was sitting right beside the site being protested? The community garden full of gardeners. Those are your partners. Go talk to them. Help us finish this plan all over the city. The gardeners, the farmers market, the children's programs, those are active parents who want cycling infrastructure to be there when those kids are there. We have the potential for my kid to be able to pedal from Yonge Street to Seneca College out there without ever thinking about being threatened by a car. But we need you to go out there and find the people in the community who will rally with you. Every cyclist, but everyone with sympathy for the cyclists and a passion for cycling. Find your supporters, find our supporters. We got to get it done by finding all our partners. That's a summer's job. When we're all outside, that's when we'll find each other. Help me with that task. Have a good ride tonight.
My battery is running out, so you cannot call me later. My battery is dead already.
Well, welcome back, Toronto.
Yeah.
It's been nearly a year since we were here last. We stood under these trees, we rode on Jarvis, we protested the slated removal of the Jarvis Street bike lanes.
Woo!
A year's passed,
and what's changed? The bike lanes are still there.
Woo!
What have we learned?
We've learned that collision rates across the board have gone down since the Jarvis Street bike lanes were installed on these streets. We've learned that the cost to rip them out and replace that fifth reversible turning lane is over $250,000.
Gravy lane!
Gravy lane!
We've learned that the street is working for everyone. The street is safer than it was 3 years ago. It's safer than it was 2 years ago. And we know that this decision that's been put on the table wants to see this street turn back into a highway. We can change this. This is one thing we can see overturned. Cycle Toronto's been working really, really hard on this. We put a request to the city for an environmental assessment. Why? Because these bike lanes, the decision was made without any due process, without any public consultation. We want to see the public consulted with before this street is turned back into a highway. The city, of course, said, well, sorry, we're not interested in doing an environmental assessment. So we've gone on to the province. We want to see the province issue orders for an environmental assessment on this very street. We haven't heard anything from the province, but that's where it's at. So tonight we ride. It's a year later, we're a year stronger. Cycle Toronto's almost 2,400 members strong. Tonight, we ride for Jarvis, we ride for Toronto. We'll see you at City Hall.
It's a great crowd.
It is a great crowd. And a beautiful day.
Beautiful day.
We're just going to jump on the street?
We're going to come straight up the...
Straight up this
way? Yeah. This is the spot to be, for sure.
Give me that key sign again.